I've been waiting a long time for this moment to come. I'm destined for anything at all.
So I'm a professor at Stanford in both the physics department and up at Slack National Accelerator Lab. I play cello, my husband's a violist, so we play a lot of string quartets. Grew up on the Stanford campus at a time when it was pretty exciting. There were actually student riots and demonstrations in the late 60s, early 70s when I was a kid. Every once in a while I got a whiff of tear gas. A wife and a mother of three, including a Stanford senior who's supposed to graduate next month. We've got our fingers crossed. I like to read a lot of books. What do I like about books? So I'm in science and physics, and we in physics like to think of ourselves as really very technically minded, but in the end it's all about the people. One of the ways I like to learn about people is by reading books. It was really daunting and intimidating. And there are so many books. The fact that all the law authors had to be living, as I mentioned, was a specific challenge. I talked to a huge number of people to get them to help, give me advice. The two books that I came to quite early were the Physics for Future Presidents and Radioactive. Totally different books. And I liked the fact that they were about as diametrically opposed as you could imagine two books to be. Choosing the third book took me, I think, quite literally months. My Year of Meats was this struggle to find the right novel, and then when I found it, I remember getting up on a Saturday morning and just drinking my coffee and sitting in a chair for four straight hours, laughing out loud until I got to the end of the book. It's just wickedly funny. The Physics for Future Presidents, the way I'm characterizing that is it's a self-help book. Radioactive is... it is just beautiful. It's a love story about the most famous science love story between Marie and Pierre Curie. Some of the colors she invented for this book. I mean, I'd like to decorate my house.
Yeah.
In this palette. Well, I'm dying to see how the students like the book. I mean, I'm a little nervous that I want it to be successful. I want the students to be engaged. I'll be really curious to see how the students approach the books. But I think it's just a terrific program. So it's just been fun to be part of it. The one point I like to make that I think is important is that books can be grazed. The Physics for Future Presidents in particular, maybe you're not interested in terrorism, which is the first chapter, so, you know, flip to climate change. Some books, like the novel, has to be read cover to cover. I think you miss a lot. And actually with Radioactive also, it's a book that you can read a page in one place and read a page in another, and actually you'll get something out of it. In the end, you want to read it cover to cover. What's my favorite spot to read a book? Well, I can tell you where I most often read a book is on an airplane. My favorite spot to read a book is in the morning in the living room of my house, which has a lot of light, with a cup of coffee sitting next to me. I'm trying to sleep. I'm trying. I think it's always important that books can be approached in many different ways. Mm-hmm.